Hello students, welcome back to Master AK tutorial. Today we want to talk about equilibrium of forces. As you can see, there are two types of equilibrium of forces. We have the static and the dynamic equilibrium. Okay, so the static equilibrium and the dynamic equilibrium. The static equilibrium is when the body as a whole remains at rest and does not rotate at all. Okay, so in that case, the velocity, the linear velocity of the object is zero, and the angular velocity is equal to zero too. Okay, because the object is at rest, that is, the object is not moving, and it does not rotate, that is, it's not rotating, therefore the angular velocity is zero. So we also have the dynamic equilibrium, in which the dynamic equilibrium is when the body moves in a straight line with a constant speed or rotates with a constant angular velocity. Okay, when you talk about dynamic equilibrium, the body is moving but with a very constant, with a constant speed. Okay, and also it may not be going in a straight line with a constant speed, it may be rotating but with a constant angular velocity. Okay, that is, the velocity is, linear velocity is a constant, is a non-zero constant. Okay, and the angular velocity is also a non-zero constant. Okay, so in both cases we talk about a dynamic equilibrium. Okay, so now let us look at the conditions for static equilibrium under the action of coplanar forces. Okay, so when talking about static equilibrium, when an object is in a state of static equilibrium, there are two conditions that are attached to it. That is, the first one, the algebraic sum of the forces acting on the body in any given direction must be equal to zero. That is, the sum of the forces applied, the external forces applied, the sum of all the external forces applied should give you vector null. That is, when you do the projection on the x-axis, it will be equal to zero, and when you do the projection on the other axis, that is the y-axis, it is zero, and the, if there is a third axis, if it is it should be just in two axes, because we are talking about coplanar forces, that is, forces in a plane that can be represented on a plane. Okay, so the sum of the forces in the first axis will be equal to zero, then in the second axis is also equal to zero. Okay, so the second condition here is the algebraic sum of the moment of all forces about any point on the body must be zero. Here we see that there is a word here, moment. Okay, there is a separate video in which I've explained about moment. Okay, so here we just want to talk about moments in which it can be applied to get to calculate values or quantities when an object is at rest. That is, an object that can rotate about a fixed point being at rest, that implies that the algebraic sum of its moment is equal to zero. The meaning of this is that sum of the moment in the clockwise direction is equal to the sum of the moment in the anticlockwise direction. Okay, we're going to do an example to make it clear, to make the statement on condition of equilibrium, condition for static equilibrium very clear. But the example is going to be on the first condition. Okay, it's going to be on the first condition, because there are other classes, there are other videos that have made specially on moment. Okay, so which means that you have to watch those ones in order to see the example for the second condition. Okay, so now the example, let's now go for the example. Okay, now the example goes thus. Let's write example. Okay, let's say an object of mass 5 kg is at rest on a rough surface okay inclined by an angle theta is equal to 30 degrees to the horizontal okay calculate the friction let's say the frictional force applied to it from the surface. Now we're going to take G is equal to 10 meter per second. Okay? For the sake of for making it clear, let us so that's it. Now let's represent the object in the question so that there won't be any ambiguity. Let's say this is the angle theta and this is the object, okay? So this is the example that we are asked to solve. An object of mass 5 kg is at rest on a rough surface inclined by an angle theta is equal to 30 degrees to the horizontal. Calculate the friction, the frictional force applied to it. Okay, apply to it from the surface. Okay, so let's solve this. Now, solution. Okay, solution. Now, here we have. Let's represent again the object. Let's show the object here. Let's say this is the object and we have theta here, okay? This is the object and we have theta here. So now the forces that are applied to the object, okay? The forces that are applied to the object. We always have the weight, okay? Then we have the normal reaction, which is always perpendicular to the surface. This is it. Now we have been told here that the surface is rough, so it means that there are frictional forces here, and those ones are the ones we have been told to calculate. The frictional force is the one we have been told to even calculate, so therefore there is a frictional force, and the frictional force is always going towards what, the opposite direction to the motion. You can see the object is supposed to slide down, therefore the frictional force will be going the opposite direction, so that's why I represented in that way, okay? So now these are the three forces. Now, for clarity, let me represent it here again in a bolder way. Okay. Now, let us apply a frame of reference to this. That is, let's put the y-axis here. Let's use the y-axis and the x-axis here. Let's say this is the x-axis, okay? So this is the x-axis and this is the y-axis, okay? We have theta here. You can see that theta will come back here. And which way will theta come back here? Okay, these two lines, this line is perpendicular to this line and this line is perpendicular to this line. So therefore, the angle here will appear here too, okay? So we have theta here too. So now, you can do the projection here of these forces on x axis and y axis. Okay. Now, we can do the projection on the two axes. Okay, but we're going to do for x only, right? Because we're looking for the frictional force F, and you can see that this is our x axis, and all the frictional force is on x. So if you do it on the y axis, you won't get any component of the frictional force on the y axis. So you can do it on both, but for this example, we only need the projection on x. So let's just say projection along x. So now let's look at it. The projection along x. The frictional force F is going in the positive x direction. Okay, and all of it is along the x direction. So along x, the frictional force F is still, okay, let's write it this way, Fx. We apply this force condition in which we have been told that the algebraic sum of the forces applied to the object is equal to zero. So let's first of all write F, you have three forces here, the component of them on x. You have a small letter Fx, which is the component of frictional force on x, plus Rx plus Wx is equal to zero. Okay, so this is along x. Okay, now along x, now let's look at it. Fx is equal to F, right? Fx is equal to F. Okay, then look at it. R is perpendicular to x, because R is along y, and y is perpendicular to x. Therefore, the component of R on x is zero, okay? Because it's perpendicular. Okay, so you will now write plus Rx is zero, because R on x is zero, because the component of R on x is zero. So now look at W now, I mean the weight. Now Wx is this line, this distance. Okay, which can be represented on x here. Okay, so this distance, which is also this distance, is the component of W on x, which is called yx. Okay, how to get this yx? Look at this small right angle triangle. Yx is the opposite side to this small right angle triangle. So therefore, using one of the trigonometric ratio, which is the sine, using the sine, you can get this yx, in which yx is equal to, look at it, it's the minus, it's the negative x. So you write minus y sine theta. Well, minus y sine theta because it's a negative x, that's number one. Then y sine because it's opposite to theta here. So now W is the hypotenuse, okay? This length here, right, the hypotenuse of this small right angle triangle is W, okay? So therefore, all this here will be equal to zero, okay? So now we can proceed, and I'm going to clean the projection down here so that we'll be able to continue with our calculation, okay? So now, we now have it here, this way, and we are looking for the small letter F, which is the frictional force. So making the small letter F the subject of our formula, so we have F is equal to W sine theta, right? So, and F, we know that W is equal to mg, right? We know that W is equal to mg. Therefore, we now have mg sine theta. Now look at it, the mass is 5 kg is given to us. They told us to take g is equal to 10, given to us. And theta is given as 30 degrees. Okay? So you have 5 times 10 times sine 30. So 5 times 10 is 50, right? Now sine 30 is equal to 0.5, right? So this F is equal to 25 newton. Okay, so here you can see that the frictional force that is preventing this object to slide down, that is the frictional force that is making the object, along with the two other forces that is making the object to remain at rest, is equal to 25 newton. Okay, So that is why the object is not sliding down. Okay, so I hope this video is helpful. I hope you have learned one or two things. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.